Coming in at number one is how you navigate the menu at the bottom of your phone. So it is very important to take note that if you've selected the page and it's highlighted in purple, your menu is going to display up to 4 or 5 options. If you've selected a particular element, the menu then becomes more, because the system is asking you, what do you want to do with that element that you've selected? Whereas if you've selected the whole page, you only have the option to manipulate the page on its own. So these are the options that are available per page. It would be to replace the page, color, animate, layers, which we're going to do a little bit later, and animate as well, as well as the ellipses or the more menu. So take note, whenever you're designing using your phone, make sure and be aware what it is that you've selected. Have you selected the page or have you selected an element? That's how it's going to help you, guide you on the menu option that's going to display at the bottom of the page. So with the bottom of the page, if you've selected the whole page and you open up the ellipses or the more menu, you can only use the options that are available, which is copy, paste, and comment. But if you've selected an element, like I'm selecting my element, you have more to do with that particular element that you've selected. And with even the more menu, there's more menu available or menu options available for that element that you've selected. So it's very important to take note what it is that you have selected on your design that's going to guide you so that you don't get confused. Coming in at number two, it is to group your elements on Canva. So say you've designed this design and you've got different kinds of shapes on your design and you want to group them. So you would select the first element that you would like to group, and then you move to the bottom of the page and you go to your menu. On your menu page, you're going to find the three dots. So you're going to click on the three dots or open up the three dots, and then the more menu is going to open up, and then you're going to click on select multiple. Once you click on select multiple, it will then highlight the first shape that you've selected to be grouped, and then you select the second one, it would show you two, it would show you three. So every time you select an element, it shows you the number of elements that you've selected. Now, if you decide you want to group them, the number that you've chosen, you would slide on your menu until you find the group option and you click on group. And then it would show all of them in one as group. And again, if you have left and you want to come back to your design and now you want to ungroup, you just need to select the group that you've wanting to ungroup, and then go to the menu at the bottom of the page and click ungroup, and then they are ungrouped. How do you deal with layers on your design? So with the menu at the bottom of the page, it would show you the layers if you've selected the whole page. So say, for example, we've selected an element. We need to scroll all the way to almost the end of the page to pick up layers. But if you've selected the whole page, then layers will show at once. So if we want to see our layers and manipulate the layers, and we are on the page, we would click on the layers menu, and then it would display all of the layers that we've created for the particular design. Selected the menu, it would show you all layers. It would also show you layers that are overlapping on top of each other. So that's the options that are available there. The menu on the side of each layer, these 6 dots that you could see, mean that you could hold the layer and then you could align it and edit below another layer, and then you could manipulate your designs that way so that you put your designs exactly the way that you want them. Layers are very, very useful when we are designing. That's why softwares like Photopea and Photoshop and Adobe Illustrators are all about layers. So the sooner you start learning layers and using your layers, the sooner you're going to do better with other softwares that we're going to be using to design. one of the most valuable tools. I'm not saying the other tools are not valuable, but when you're designing, especially an intricate design like we're doing for Digital Dream Delights, and there's different kinds of shapes that we're manipulating, the menu at the bottom of the page, when you scroll all the way to the end, there's a nudge option that's available. This is so valuable when you're designing on your phone. We don't have nudge on a computer because you can use a mouse. Whereas if you're on your phone, the nudge tool is very valuable to move little elements to exactly where you want for them to be. So I wanted to show you the nudge tool. Next is our very cool animate tool. So if you want to animate any element, say for example, we want to animate this element on our design, we would select the element and then we would scroll until you find animate, and you select animate, and there's an option to animate using the normal animation. When you scroll through, you get to view the new edit AI tools that Canva has added on their animation, the create animation, as well as the rotate, you know, the motion effects that they've just added. So you have these beautiful options that are available. When you select create animation, you can just move the animation the way that you want, and then you can adjust it as you want. The last tip I want to show you when I'm designing on my phone is if you've selected an element and you would like to edit the element, you could select the element, click on edit. The phone would then, or the software would, zoom in to allow you to type in an element if it is a shape that you would, that you're busy using and you're designing. If you don't want that, you just click on back, and then you can just use your two fingers and squeeze them together so that you can zoom back in. So with designing small little elements like I'm doing with this design, Canva sometimes, it flickers twice. And when it flickers twice, sometimes it doesn't allow us to move an element. So don't despair. If you click twice and maybe you want to duplicate and it doesn't duplicate, like exactly what I've done now, just select it and you say duplicate and it doesn't. You just need to click outside and click on it again, up until it doesn't flicker. And I think this is something we need to tell Canva and notify them, that when we're designing on the phone, it doesn't allow us to delete if it flickers twice. So this is, I think, a software glitch that Canva needs to fix, because it didn't used to do this before. It used to work beautifully. But what I want, the last thing that I want to show you, if you've selected an element, there's an option of duplicate, delete, and the three ellipses. So if you click on the ellipses, then populate a menu at the bottom of the page like we've been doing. And then you can start grouping, sending to back, locking, etc., etc. if you are using your phone. I hope this has added value. Stuart, you asked for this, and I hope it's going to add value. Let me know what else I can help on the phone. But I can't stress enough, you need to go get that little dongle so that it makes your life while you're designing on your phone easier. And I think I paid like 100 rands, South African rands. It's probably $14 or $7 if you're using a dollar currency. Thank you so much for joining me for this quick tutorial. I hope you've enjoyed it. I will see you on the next video.